Okay, so talking about different uses of modals today. First of all, this word that you see in capital letters, it is modal, not model, not modal verbs, but modal verbs. We can call them modals or modal verbs. And I hope you guys understand English. Do all of you here understand what I speak, or do I need to use Hindi also? If you can't understand me, please let me know. But I must say that you have to familiarize yourself with English. If you're always comfortable in Hindi, you'll always be comfortable in it, but you will not learn English. You might feel a little uncomfortable understanding English, but that's okay. That will help you get better and to actually improve your listening, your understanding, your speaking skills in English. So even if you feel a little uncomfortable and you have to pay extra attention, please do that, because that's how you're going to develop your listening in English. So I hope you understand that. Is there anyone who doesn't understand English here? Please let me know if that's the case. I can try to explain. Anyways, agar samajh mein nahi aayega, you can raise your hand at any time and ask me. Ke ye aap explain kar do, I'll be happy to do that. So now talking about today's topic, that is modals. First of all, what are modals? Let's first talk about the words that are modals. कौन कौन से वर्ड्स मॉडल्स होते हैं? वर्ड्स लाइक कैन, कुड, मे, माइट, शैल, शुड, वुड, हैव टू, नीड टू, ऑट टू, ये जो सारे वर्ड्स हैं वी कॉल देम मॉडल्स. सो मॉडल्स आर नॉट लाइक नॉर्मल वर्ब्स. मॉडल्स आर, वी कैन से मॉडल्स आर स्पेशल वर्ब्स एंड दे हैव स्पेशल फंक्शंस व्हेन वी स्पीक. What role they have, what job they do, let's talk about that. So modals broadly have 8 usage. Use number 1, we use modals to talk about our ability or our capacity. Matlab jo kaam hum kar pate hain, hamare andar kabiliyat hai, yogyata hai, kshamta hai, that's ability. Number 2, we use modals to talk about possibility. कोई चीज हो सकती है, नहीं हो सकती है, होगी नहीं होगी, possibility. We use models to talk about possibility. Number 3, we also use models to make a request or to ask for permission. हमें कुछ करना है तो हम हमको किसी से कुछ चाहिए तो हमें उनको request करना पड़ेगा. हमें कुछ करना है तो we need permission. So we use models for this. Number 4, we also use modals to talk about a duty or obligation. Life में हमारे कुछ duties होते हैं, तो to talk about our duties, our obligations, we use modals. Number 5, we use modals to talk about necessity. Necessity means it's very important to do that. You can't avoid it, so that's a necessity. To express that necessity, we use modals. Number 6, we also use modals to make a suggestion to somebody, to give an advice to somebody. Number 7, we use modals for a logical conclusion. Logical conclusion means we think ki koi cheez hua hai to uska kya reason raha hoga, ya aisa kyon hua hoga. That's our conclusion, that's our understanding. So when we communicate that conclusion, we use modals. We'll talk about it. Next one, we also use modals to make an offer, to make offers. Kisi ko kuch dena hai, offer karna hai, we use modals for that as well. So what we will do is we will discuss all these uses one by one. We will discuss which model, which all models we use for a particular thing. For example, which all models do we use to talk about ability or possibility or any other thing. So that is what we are going to discuss during this class today. Hi, Simran. Yes, I'm feeling well, actually. I'm not sick today, so that's good thing. Let's talk about use number one, that's ability or capacity. We use modals to talk about ability. Ability matlab hum kya kar sakte hain, kya karne ki hamare andar kshamta hai, yogyata hai, that's ability. Aur usko capacity bol sakte hain, ability bol sakte hain, ek jaisi cheeze hain, but I have written two words ताकि आप थोड़ा अंडरस्टैंड कर पाए. टू टॉक अबाउट एबिलिटी और कैपेसिटी वी यूज द वर्ड कैन. टू टॉक अबाउट अवर एबिलिटी इन प्रेजेंट, अभी के टाइम पे मेरे अंदर क्या क्या काबिलियत है, मैं क्या कर सकती हूँ, मतलब क्या करना मेरे को आता है, उसके लिए वी यूज कैन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई कैन सिंग वेरी वेल, or I can drive a sports car. So these are my abilities. I can do these things. So we use the word can. We all use the word can for Hindi speakers. For example, agar hamare ko bolna hai ki mereko sports car ya mereko chess khelna aata hai, to hum bol sakte hain I can play chess, ya main chess khel sakti hu. I can play chess. यहाँ पर हम क्या बोल रहे हैं? We are talking about an ability. So we use the word can. And if we are expressing a past ability, अभी की ability के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं तो we use can. But if we are expressing a past ability, we use could. Past ability means something that the ability that I had in the past. For example, when I was in my school, I could run 100 meters in 20 seconds. So I could run 100 meters in 20 seconds. That's my past ability, not the current ability, not the present ability, but the past ability. So what happens is, could is only used in past when we are talking about someone's ability. When we are talking about ability, we use can for present and could for past. I hope you understood that. Is that clear to you? Is there anyone who hasn't understood it? Please let me know. Lucky, do you have a question?
No, ma'am. I raise my hand with my example.
Okay, please share an example. Now I can't hear Lucky. Kajal, do you have a question?
No, ma'am. I have example, ma'am.
So please share two examples with me. Good evening, Kajal. Please share two examples with me. One for can and the other for could.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I can wander Noida alone.
I can wander, W-A-N-D-E-R, wander. Okay, I can wander around Noida alone. Okay, that's good.
Now, and second one, ma'am, when I to standard, I could run in my school to 100 meters.
Okay, yes, you can say that. So to talk about a past ability, we use could. To talk about a present ability, we use can. So yes, let's have some examples from you guys. Let me ask Eagle to share some examples.
Hi, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Eagle. How are you today?
I'm fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
I'm good too. Please share examples with can and could to talk about ability.
I can play the piano well.
All right.
I could dance well.
When could you dance well?
And I could dance well when I am 5 years old.
When I was 5 years old. Good. Yes. So that's what you will say. Good. So yes, that's how it works. We think that could is the past form for can, which is true, but that is only when you're talking about some past ability. That's when you use could in the past. Apart from that, iske alawa, we use could in the present all the time. We will discuss that going forward. So that was use number one. I hope that's clear to everyone. Yeah, I cannot speak English. I can dance. I can go to market. I can speak English. I can cook very well. Can you speak English? Absolutely right. You can do all these examples. Can you guys share some examples of past ability with me? Past ability, things you could do in the past. And for those who are new, if you don't know how to participate during the class, you need to raise your hand. If you raise your hand, I'll unmute you and you can speak. Okay, so let me ask Nandini to share examples.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Nandini.
Ma'am, I can try to speak in spoken English every day.
What does this mean?
मैम मैं रोज इंग्लिश बोलने की कोशिश करती हूँ
तो कैन की तो रिक्वायरमेंट ही नहीं है ना आई ट्राई टू स्पीक
ओके मैम आई कैन मेक कुक आई कैन डांस
यस दैट्स दैट कैन बी करेक्ट आई कैन डांस दैट मींस यू नो हाउ टू डांस एंड यू आर एबल टू डांस
ओके
ओके फॉर गुड
I couldn't make food in age of 18.
Good. Yes. When I was 18, I couldn't cook.
Okay.
Can you say that? When I was 18, I couldn't cook.
When I was 18, I couldn't cook food.
That's right. That's what you will say.
Okay.
Thank you, Nandini. Now let's go to Lucky. Lucky, please share your examples.
Yes, ma'am. My example, ma'am, I can dance.
Right.
And ma'am, I can drive car.
Mm-hmm.
And ma'am, my good example is, ma'am, she could speak several languages.
Several languages, okay.
And ma'am.
Lucky, मेरे को तीन चीजें बताओ जो आप नहीं कर पाते थे जब आप छोटे थे.
Okay, ma'am, I could not jump.
Good.
And ma'am, I could not eat hard food.
That's right.
And ma'am, I could not run fast.
Wonderful. That's right, Lucky. Great. So that's how you use could. Past mein aapko ye cheezein nahi pata tha aapko. Aapke andar ye ability nahi thi. So that's how you speak. Moving on. Can is equal to be able to. Can or able to ka matlab ek hi hota hai. So, हम कैन की जगह पे एबल टू भी यूज कर सकते हैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई कैन नॉट कम वी कैन ऑल्सो से आई एम नॉट एबल टू कम सो वी सिंग बी एबल टू बी कुड बी इज एम आर वॉज वर विल बी एटसेट्रा इट कैन बी एनी थिंग बी मीन्स एनी ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स इज एम आर वॉज वर विल बी बिन एटसेट्रा So if you want to say, I can cook, you can also say, I am able to cook. Or I can conduct the class. You can also say, I am able to conduct the class. Or I could not conduct the class yesterday. I can also say, I was not able to conduct the class yesterday. Or like Lucky said, I could not eat hard food when I was a child. He can also say, I was not able to eat hard food when I was a child. You can use be able to also. You can use can and could also. So can you speak some sentences using the expression be able to? And be able to matlab, you will use Is able to, am able to, are able to, etc. Or it could be was able to, for past, was able to. So please use. Let me ask Jitendra. Hi, Jitendra, are you able to mute yourself? Okay, I can't hear Jitendra, so I'll go to Aditya.
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Aditya.
Okay, so I am able to dance.
Good.
I am able to sing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not able to go to school.
Good. Yes. And can you also use was able to or was not able to? Okay. Let me ask Simran. Simran, could you share some examples?
Yeah. Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Simran.
So I was not able to travel alone earlier.
All right. Yes, that's correct.
Children are not able to cook food by themselves.
That's right. Children are not able. Children, actually.
Children. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
That's right. I'm able to speak four languages.
Wow. Okay. Yeah.
Yes, that's it, ma'am. Thank
that's
you.
Right. So that's how we can use be able to. And I am not able to. को हम जैसा काजल ने बोला वी कैन से आई एम अनेबल टू आई एम नॉट एबल टू कुक फूड मींस आई एम अनेबल टू कुक फूड आई एम नॉट एबल टू कंडक्ट योर क्लास मींस आई एम अनेबल टू कंडक्ट योर क्लास वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज दैट नंदिनी सेज आई विल बी एबल टू स्पीक परफेक्ट इंग्लिश वेरी सून दैट्स करेक्ट नंदिनी राहुल सेज आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू अटेंड ऑफिस यस्टरडे ग्रेट यस गाइज दोज ऑफ यू who are not participating here can participate in the chat as well. I read all the sentences and if there is any feedback, I'll share it with you. So guys, that is how we use can and could to talk about capacity. There are many other usage. We are going to discuss them. This was use number one. We use be able to. Now I want to talk to you about, so we use these structures, I told you, is MR plus able to, was, were, or will be plus able to talk about different timings. Can ki jagah pe is MR able to, could ki jagah pe was able to, were able to. Future form nahi hota, can, could ka, toh main will be able to hi use karna hota hai. For example, I will be able to reach on time, or I will not be able to reach on time. That's how we use it. Now, there is this very common mistake when we say, I can't be able to come today. Or I can't be able to talk right now. That's not correct. You will say, I can't talk right now. Or I'm not able to talk right now. Or I'm unable to talk right now. But you will not say, I can't be able to talk. Please avoid this. Or sometimes people say, yeah, sorry, I could not able to call you. That's also incorrect. You will say, sorry, I couldn't call you. Or sorry, I was not able to call you. But you will not use can, could, and be able to in the same sentence. That's incorrect. So I hope that's clear to you. Great, Nandini. Nandini says, I have been able to swim since I was 8. And that's correct. Great job. Now let's move on. Let's talk about use number 2. That is to talk about possibility. We also use modals to talk about possibility as we discuss. Possibility matlab koi cheez ho sakti hai future mein ya nahi ho sakti hai. That's possibility. Abhi to humne apni khud ki ability ki baat kari ya kisi ki bhi ability ki baat kari. The next use is possibility. These are the words we use to talk about possibility. We use can, may, could, might. We use these words. सबका मतलब फॉर एग्जाम्पल सबका एक ही मतलब होता है कि पॉसिबिलिटी है बट व्हाट्स द डिफरेंस व्हेन वी यूज डिफरेंट वर्ड्स लेट्स डिस्कस दैट सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई से इट कैन रेन और इट मे रेन और इट कुड रेन और इट माइट रेन हिंदी स्पीकर्स के लिए इन सबका मतलब यही है कि बारिश हो सकती है पॉसिबिलिटी है बारिश होने की बट In English, we have multiple words, we have different words to express different levels of possibility. If we say it can rain, that means there is very strong possibility of rain. Maybe we'll say it can rain anytime. So if you have anything outside, please bring it in. Please bring the dry clothes inside. It can rain anytime. It can rain means very strong possibility. But if we say it may rain or it could rain, that means there are 50-50 chances, maybe lesser possibility. So when we mean lesser possibility, 50-50 chances, we can use it may rain or it could rain. They have similar meanings. You can choose any word that suits you. But if we say it might rain, that is a negative expectation, actually. That's a negative possibility. Negative means 90% chances are that there will be no rain, but still there is possibility. Still there is 10% possibility. And that is when you use it might rain. So using different word will communicate different levels of possibility. So for example, say someone has invited you for a dinner this Sunday. If you are sure that you will go, tab aap seedhe seedhe bol denge, yes, I will come. I will definitely come. But if you think that there is possibility, you are not 100% sure, but there is still strong possibility. So you'll say, yeah, I'm working in the day, but I can come after 8. I can come after 8 means there's strong possibility of you going there. But say you are a bit busy and you think like, you know, you want to go, but you think you might be busy and it might not be sure. So you will use the word, yeah, though I'm busy throughout the day, I may come late in the evening, or I could come late in the evening. That means there is 50-50 possibility. But if you say, I'm sorry, I'm very busy that day, since I have this very important meeting, but in case I get time, I might come. So in case I get time, I might come. That means you are telling that person to not expect you there. They will not expect you there, but still you don't want to say no. So you're saying I might come, and there are chances. There are very less chances, but there are chances. So that is how you use the words can, may, could, might to talk about possibility. Did you understand that, guys? Any questions? Okay, Lucky, do you have a question? Please go ahead.
Ma'am, I don't understand the might word.
You don't understand might word. So what do you not understand about it? Oh, Lucky, please go ahead.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, I don't understand what is the meaning of might.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Actually, jaise can, may hai. जैसे कैन और मे वर्ड्स हैं, वैसे ही माइट भी है. क्या होता है, कैन और मे स्ट्रॉन्गर हैं, माइट थोड़ा वीक है. अगर आप किसी पॉसिबिलिटी की बात करें, फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर आप बोलें कि टीचर कैन स्कोल्ड मी, दैट मींस
मैम, जैसे मैम इट माइट रेन, तो मैम ये इसका मतलब है ना, मैम रेन हो सकती है, पक्का नहीं है इतने उससे,
बट केवल 10% चांसेस है कि होगी, 90% चांसेस है कि नहीं होगी, ऐसा आप सोच सकते हैं, है ना. इट माइट रेन का मतलब ज्यादातर चांसेस ये हैं कि बारिश नहीं होगी, बट हो भी सकती है. डू यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट? ओके. सत्या सेज शी हैज अ डाउट. सत्या, वेयर आर यू? कुड यू प्लीज रेज योर हैंड? ओके, आई कैन सी यू सत्या. यस सत्या, प्लीज गो अहेड. Please unmute yourself.
Can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, Satya, I can hear you. Please let me know.
Yeah. Ma'am, for can, you have told me that it is for strong possibility. And
that's
for
right.
50% possibility. And for might, it is very less possibility. Say for may.
So can is very strong possibility. Maybe say 80% possibility, right?
May.
And may and could be about 50-50 possibility.
Both are like same only.
Both are same. Both are same. The meaning won't change if you interchange the words. You can use any word that's suitable.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Thank you for asking that question. Yes, I really appreciate people, those who ask questions, because they don't go home with doubts. Ki class to attend kari, lekin na samajh mein nahi aaya ki class mein aaj hua kya. So, agar aapko koi cheez samajh mein nahi aa rahi hai, please ask me. That's why I'm here. My job is to answer your questions. Upendra, guys, is my voice breaking? Does it break? Upendra says there's a voice break. Can you hear me clearly, guys? Please let me know. I'm not sure. I think you are able to hear me. Okay. So do you hear me or do you not hear me? It is audible. Okay. Okay. It is clear. All right. Then Upendra, you might have network problem. Please resolve it. I have a very fast 5G internet here. So it should be very clear. But if there's a problem, please let me know. I'll talk to my internet service provider. So I hope you understood this. You know? Agar possibility kafi zyada hai, use can. Agar 50-50 possibility hai, use may and could. Agar possibility bahut hi kam hai, so use might. For example, padhai to maine waise mehnat to nahi kari hai, but pass ho bhi sakti hun. So agar maine mehnat hi nahi kari hai aur maine exam acha hi nahi likha hai, then I will not say I will pass with flying colors. I'll say though I did not work hard, but I might clear the exam if my luck favors me. So in such a case, you will use might. You will not say I can. Yeah, I can clear the exam. I can clear is when you are very sure, when it is, the possibility is high. So I hope you understood that. Let me ask some of you to share examples. Let me ask Nandini to share examples. Nandini, can you share examples with me for can, may, could, might?
Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible. Please go ahead.
Okay. I can drink water.
Okay.
May I drink a water?
ये तो आप permission के लिए बोल रहे हैं, तुम केवल possibility की बात करें. We are only talking about possibility right now.
Okay. It's can a sunny day.
It can be a sunny day. Can okay. be a sunny day.
It can be a sunny day.
Mm-hmm.
It may be a sunny day.
Mm-hmm.
It could be a sunny day.
Mm-hmm.
It might be a sunny day.
And what does it mean if you say it might be a sunny day?
It means, ma'am, possibility was not.
And when will you say this to someone? When will you say it might be a sunny day? Kyun bologe aap?
Because, ma'am, climate was very cloudy.
Okay. That's right. In such a situation, when it is actually very cloudy, it's been raining, there is a forecast that it's going to rain, but it might be sunny. So very less possibility. Good. I'm happy that you guys got it. So use the words according to your situation. If you want to give high hopes, use can. If you want to give less hopes, use might when you talk to people. Okay. Somebody said they had a question. Who has a question? Mahima has a question. Mahima, could you please raise your hand? I can't find you. Okay. Go ahead, Mahima. Please ask.
Ma'am, like you said, we have to use could in the past.
And then I also said only when we are talking about ability.
Okay, ma'am. Like if someone asks me a question, that time I have to answer him in present.
नहीं I'm sorry, first of all, I interrupted. I shouldn't have, but yeah, let me explain it to you. Actually, we use could in the present all the time. All the time. We only use could in the past when we are talking about a past ability.
Okay, ma'am.
Only when we are talking about a past ability. Remember the word ability? When it's past ability, we use could. Otherwise, we use could in the present a lot of time. A lot means all the time.
Okay, ma'am.
Did you understand it now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's great then. Thank you for asking that question. All right. So I hope you guys understood it. Swati says, I invite her. Might be she will come. That's right, Swati. So might be means the chances of her coming on your invitation are less. So you are not very hopeful. So when we say might, we are not very hopeful. Please remember that. So guys, that was use number two. We use these modals to talk about a possibility. Possibility, ab aap bologe, possibilities, abhi hum possibility ki baat karenge, to future ke liye karenge. Past mein kaise use karna hai, uske baare mein hum baat mein karenge. Agar hum kisi past ki possibility ki baat karein, tab hum kaise baat karenge, we will talk about that later. Right now, we'll only talk about ki abhi kisi possibility ki baat karni hai, future ke liye, to hum kaise baat karenge. That's what we're discussing right now. Now, let's move on. I'll leave this. Let's go to use number three. Use number three is to seek a permission. So we use modals to ask for permission. We need permission from people a lot of time. So when we are asking for permission, we can use these words: can, could, may, would, etc. Permission means I want to do something, so I need your permission. Like if I quickly want to take a break right now, so I need your permission, I can use these words. Take a look at this example first. It says, can I sit here? Could I sit here? May I sit here? Would you mind if I sat here? In all these sentences, I'm asking your permission. Main aapse puch rahi hu ki main yahan pe baith jaun. If I was talking to you in Hindi, I would say, excuse me, ma'am, kya main yahan pe baith jaun? So in Hindi, we only have one word. Kya main yahan pe baith jaun? Kya main yahan pe baith sakti hun? Or in Hindi or in other Indian languages, maybe. But in English, we have multiple words depending on the situation we are in and depending on who we are talking to, we can choose a word. You see the arrow? Can is informal, and from can coming towards may and would, it becomes very formal. So, can I sit here? Where will you use can I sit here? You will use can I sit here when you're talking to your family or your friends, people who are very close to you. You can use can I sit here. It is informal. Informal matlab aise language jo hum apne friends and family ke sath use karte hain. Next sentence, you see, could I sit here? Could I sit here is a very nice and a polite expression. Like most of us are professionals. We work and we talk to our colleagues. We talk to people at work. We talk to our clients. We talk to customers. So we should use this word. We should use could a lot. When we are asking permission, we should use could. Like, could I talk to you for a few minutes? Could I discuss something with you? Could I sit here, etc. So you should use the word could a lot. The next word is may. May I sit here? We use may when we are talking to somebody who is much superior, like who is very high in power and authority. We use may I sit here. For example, in schools, we said, may I come in, ma'am, etc. Because in schools, we were very young, we were kids, and the teachers were, you know, we respected them a lot. So we used may I sit here, may I come in, etc. The next expression, would you mind if? We will use this expression mainly when we are talking to somebody who we don't know well. Or if we are talking to a stranger, then we will use this expression, would you mind if I? And please also note that we are saying, would you mind if I sat here? Not sit here, but if I sat here. If you take a look at it, we are using sat, the second form of the verb. So that is how you can use the words can, could, may, and would you mind if I to ask for permission. किसी भी चीज की परमिशन हो सकती है, जैसे मुझे आपसे बात करनी है, अगर आप मेरे फ्रेंड हैं, I'll say, can I talk to you? क्या मैं आपसे बात कर सकती हूँ? Can I talk to you? If you are my colleague, if I work with you, or even if you are my student, because my relationship with you is a formal relationship, you are my student. So I'll say, could I talk to you? Or like in the class, I always say, could you speak? Could you unmute yourself? I don't use can because our relationship is formal. But if I'm talking to somebody, for example, if I'm talking to maybe my boss, or if I'm talking to a client, I might use, may I sit here? May I talk to you? May I talk to you for a couple of minutes? I'll use may. But if I'm outside somewhere, and maybe I'm in a hospital, I'm at a bank, and I don't know that person well, so I'll say, would you mind if I sat here? Would you mind if I used your pen? Etc. So that's how you can use different expressions in different situations. So I have explained it to you. Now it's your job to share examples. I hope you understood it. Guys, did you get it? Did you understand this? If you did, please let me know. Okay, Mahima says, why are we using second form in the sentence? Yeah, that's right. Actually, would is normally used in imaginary situations. And when we talk about imaginary situations, we use second forms of verbs. You remember, for example, if you want to say, if I imagine that I had, if I imagine that I have $1 billion, so I'll say, if I had $1 billion. So when we're talking about imagination, we use the past tense to talk about imagination. So here we say, would you mind if I sat here? It's actually an imaginary situation. अभी मैं बैठ नहीं रही हूँ. मैंने आपसे बैठने को पूछा ही नहीं है. मैंने तो आपसे पूछा, आपको बुरा तो नहीं लगेगा अगर मैं बैठूंगी तो. मैंने ये नहीं बोला मुझे बैठना है, मैंने बोला अगर मैं बैठूंगी. It's like imaginary. It's hypothetical. अभी मैं बैठ ही नहीं हूँ. So we speak like this. Would you mind if I sat here? Like, would you mind if I, mind if I ended this class right now, for example? Now, this is something you might not like. कि एक तो कल भी इसने क्लास नहीं करी और आज ये क्लास में आई तो अभी कह रही है अभी खत्म कर देते हैं. तो मेरे को आपको बहुत ही ज्यादा माइल्ड, बहुत ज्यादा पोलाइटली पूछना पड़ेगा, बहुत ज्यादा फॉर्मली पूछना पड़ेगा. तो मैं बोलूंगी, वुड यू माइंड इफ आई एंडेड द क्लास हियर? इट्स लाइक, आपको बुरा तो नहीं लगेगा अगर मैं ये क्लास आज यहाँ पे खत्म कर दूं? तो मैंने क्लास खत्म करी नहीं है, मैं बस सपोजिटली आपसे पूछ रही हूँ, हाइपोथेटिकली पूछ रही हूँ कि अगर ऐसा होता है तो क्या होगा. सो दैट्स इमेजिनरी सिचुएशन. एंड टॉक अबाउट इमेजिनरी सिचुएशंस, वी यूज सेकंड फॉर्म्स ऑफ वर्ब्स. आई होप यू गॉट दैट. सो वी विल ऑलवेज यूज सेकंड फॉर्म्स ऑफ वर्ब्स. जस्ट यूज दिस एक्सप्रेशन, वुड यू माइंड इफ आई सैट हियर? Would you mind if I ended the class early? Would you mind if I did not attend the session today? Would you mind if I called you later? That's what you're going to use all the time when you use this expression. So I hope I answered your question, Mahima. I hope you understood it. Now let's go ahead and let me hear out your examples. Yeah, what do you have to say? So since, okay, those of you who are new, you need to raise your hand. How do you need to raise your hand? Zoom has the option, Zoom has a reactions button. You will go to reactions, and when you go to reactions, you will see raise hand. You need to use that. Click on raise hand. Like right now, you can see I have raised my hand. If you click on raise hand, you can raise your hand. So that's how you need to raise your hand, guys. Please follow that. Okay, now let me go to Aditya first. Where is Aditya? Yes, Aditya.
Yes, ma'am.
Please share examples.
So, can I go there?
Mm-hmm.
Could I go there?
I also want to know when you will use can I go there and when you will use could I go there.
Ma'am, I will use can to those whom I know.
Mm-hmm.
And ma'am, could I will use ma'am that I'm just they are like ma'am my friends and I know them well.
If you know someone well, for example, if somebody is your friend, you don't need to be very formal with them. You can be informal. You can just say, you know, can we watch a movie this Sunday maybe? Or can I talk to you? Can I ask you a question? You can use can with them. But you will use could when you need to be formal. Maybe, okay. For example, when you are talking to a teacher, you can use could as well, like could I talk to you? But normally when you are in a formal situation, like at an office or something, you will use could I talk to you. Please okay. Go ahead, Aditya, next one.
Okay, so may I go there?
Mm-hmm.
And would you mind if I go there?
Would you mind if I went there?
Okay, if I went there.
That's right. Would you mind if I went there? That's what you will say. Like, for example, you can ask your mom. You want to go somewhere, but you think, you know, your mom might not allow. That's when you can use this expression. Would you mind if I went there? Would you mind if I went out with my friends this Sunday? So you can use that expression. Okay, now let's go to Akshay. Hi, Akshay.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Akshay. How are you?
Fine, ma'am.
Great. So please share examples.
Ma'am, would you mind if I speak here without raising my hand?
Would you mind if I spoke here? Second form. Remember, sat is the second form.
Yes, ma'am. So spoken.
Nice.
Would you mind if I spoke?
Sorry. Spoke here. Hmm. Good. Okay. Share other examples as well. Great example.
Can I spoke?
Can I speak? Yes. Jawab, can I speak? Sir? Can I speak? Yes. That's right.
Can I speak?
Hmm. Okay.
And could I speak here?
That's right.
And may we go?
Yeah, that's right. May we go? May I talk to you? May I say something? That's right. So that's how you can use different expressions and different in different situations. For example, agar aapko mere ko na acha main aapse class ke baad baat kar lu, to hum bol sakte hain, could I talk to you after the class? Because can will be too direct, too informal. I'm not your friend. So you should use could. Could is formal word. So could I talk to you after the class? Rather than using can, you should use could. And could is a great word. Keep using could all the time when you talk to people. It's a good one. Yeah, could I go there? Can I take your pen? Could I go outside? That's right. Can I go there? Would you mind if you helped me? Okay. May you help me? Yeah, all these examples are fine. All right. Somebody said they had a question. Who said they had a question? Okay, Satya said she had a question. Yes, Satya, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Satya.
I can share my examples, whatever I can make.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. Go ahead.
Can I take your bike?
Right.
Hear my request.
Okay.
May I, for would, shall we make another sentence without, would you mind?
For example?
No, ma'am, I can't able to make with would, other than would you mind.
Think of you need permission for something. And then use the expression, would you mind if I, what do you need permission for, from someone?
No, ma'am, I am asking that we can
use would only in a sentence which is beginning with would you mind.
Use only would, like would I sit here?
Okay, ma'am.
Not like that. We can't use it like that. You have to use the entire expression, would you mind if I. If you need permission, you will use this expression.
Would you mind?
Would you mind if I. We use would for many other things. Would has multiple other uses. But one of those uses is when we are asking for permission. Then you will use the entire expression, would you mind if I.
Okay.
Only would won't work.
Okay, okay, ma'am. Because most of us share the examples from the sentences which begins with would you mind, like that.
That's right. Because right now we are only talking about asking for permission.
Okay, ma'am.
So for example, if you need permission to leave the class right now, how will you use this expression? Would you mind?
Would you mind? Bother if I left the class.
Nahi, would you mind bother is not the expression. Would you mind if I left the class right now?
Would you mind if I left the class right now?
That's what you will ask me.
Okay, ma'am.
Can you think of any other example?
Would you mind if I suddenly start speaking in Tamil?
Would you mind if I suddenly started speaking in Tamil? That's right. Yeah. And I would say, no, I wouldn't mind, but I would like to tell you that I don't understand Tamil. So we might not be able to communicate. That would be my answer. If you say, would you mind if, I'll say, no, I wouldn't mind. Or I'll say, no, not at all. Or that wouldn't be a problem. So that's what I will say.
I don't know Hindi.
Right. Oh, so you don't know any Hindi?
Only English and Tamil.
So when I speak Hindi sentences, do you get them or do you not get them at all?
No, don't know. But I can't understand English.
All right. So yeah, mostly I talk in English. But if you can't understand something, please let me know. Thank you. Thank you for letting me know right now.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Satya. Okay. So Mahima says, would you mind if I couldn't come to your party? Mahima, you will say, would you mind if I couldn't come to your party? Can you see my book? Could you use my book? All right, guys. Yes. So that's how you can use these words, can, could, may, would you mind if I, to ask for permission. That was use number 3. Now, moving on to the next one. Oh, and I don't know why I missed, but we can also use the same expressions to make a request. Request matlab aapse mereko kuch chahiye to tabhi bhi main ye use karungi. For example, can you come here when I'm requesting you. So can you come here? Could you come here? Could you please come here? I will use similar expressions. So we can use that as well. Now use number 4. We also use modals to talk about necessity. Necessity means something that is requirement, something you can't avoid. So necessity, bahut zaruri hai. Zaruri kaam ke liye bhi hum modals use karte hain. We use should, have to, need to, must. We use these modals. Let's take a look at the sentences. For example, aapko jana hai, aapko late ho raha hai. To abhi class ka time bhi over ho raha hai, to aapko jana hai, to aap bol sakte hain. I should go now, I have to go now, I got to go now, I need to go now, I must go now. In sare sentences ka meaning hai, ki aapko jana hai, it is necessary to go. So you can use any of these modals. I should go, I have to go, I got to go, I need to go, I must go. For Hindi speakers, in sab ka matlab ye hai ki mereko jana hai, mereko jana chahiye. So we'll use all these, we can use all these words. But you see this arrow, should is, necessity means it is strong. But should is less strong, have to, got to, need to, they become more strong. And must is the strongest word to talk about necessity. So if you say, I'm getting late, I think I should go now. So I think I should go now. It's not like it's very urgent. Okay, maybe it's time for you to leave. So I think I should go now. If you want to become, if you want to give a stronger message, you know, you can say that, no, I'm really getting late. I have to go now. or I got to go now, or I need to go now, they mean the same thing. You can use any of these expressions. I have to go now, I got to go now, I need to go now, I'm sorry, but I'm getting late, I have to go now. I'm sorry, but I'm getting late, I got to go now. I'm sorry, but I'm getting late, I'm sorry, I'm getting late, I need to go now. You can use any of these expressions, they mean the same thing. They are stronger, stronger than should. But if it is now unavoidable, if it is urgent, then you will say, I have run out of time, I must leave now. So I must leave now is the strongest, means there is no chance to stay. There is no chance you're going to stay. At all costs, you will leave. So you will say, I must go now. That's how you will use it. So for example, during Corona times, offices made only 50% attendance mandatory. So they said, okay, you should come to office 3 days a week. But if it's not Corona times, they will say, you must report in the office every day. Because when it is not Corona times, it's very important that they come to office. They will say, you must report to office. But if it is not very important, if it's not very urgent, they will say, yeah, you have to report to office 2 days in a week. You can come any 2 days. So that's how you can use the words. I hope you understood that. Now I would like you guys to share examples with me. I'll go to Abhishek. Hi, Abhishek.
Hi, madam.
How are you, Abhishek?
I am not getting the point. I got to go. What is the meaning of I got to go? What is the difference between I have to go and I got to go?
There is no difference. That's what I discussed. I have to go bhi bol sakte hain. I got to go bhi bol sakte hain. I need to go bhi bol sakte hain. That means it's important. It's necessary for you to go. They mean the same thing. They mean the same thing. You can use any of the words that you choose to. But should is less strong. Have to, got to, need to are stronger than should. And must is the strongest word when you're talking about a necessity. So now could you share some examples with me, Abhishek?
I got to learn English.
Mm-hmm. Or would you say I got to learn English, or would you say I must speak English fluently? What would you say?
Okay, I must be learn English fluently to speak
I must learn to speak English fluently. That's right. You will say I must. Like, it depends. If English is not very important for you, it is important, but it's okay. You can manage without it. Maybe you can say, I think I should learn English, or I should learn English. But if you can't, like, if you can't have a successful career without English, if you can't live a day at work without English, then maybe you will say, I must learn English. Like if you are not getting promotion because you can't speak in English, then your feeling will be, I must learn English now. So depending on the situation, you will choose the word that you should use. So I hope you got that. Let me just go to one more person. I'll go to Jitendra for examples. Jitendra, please share some examples. I don't know why I'm not able to connect with Jitendra today. It never happens. We must respect our parents. That's right, Brijesh. Jitendra, are you able to unmute? Okay, I don't know what's happening. So let me go to Simran. Simran, please share examples.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Simran.
First sentence is, we should take steam twice a day.
Okay.
Second, we have to do yoga 5 days in a week.
Mm-hmm.
Third, we got to follow all the necessary precautions.
Okay.
Fourth one, we need to maintain. I'm unable to form a sentence, ma'am.
We need to maintain what? Social distancing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. But we need to maintain the social distancing in the crowd.
Mm-hmm.
And last one, we must get vaccinated.
Yeah, wonderful examples. And I like the examples that Simran shared. Like Simran said, we need to maintain social distancing. So right now, because Corona has been there for 2 years, तो अभी हम सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को उतना ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं दे रहे हैं बिकॉज इट हैज बिकम वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू लिव विदाउट द सोसाइटी. वी स्टिल नीड टू मेंटेन, बट हमारी फीलिंग अभी मस्ट जैसी नहीं रह गई है, बट वी मस्ट गेट वैक्सीनेटेड, देन द अदर वेरिएंट्स विल नॉट इम्पैक्ट यू. सो वी विल यूज मस्ट फॉर इट बिकॉज वैक्सीनेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो यू वुड लाइक टू गिव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग मैसेज. सो गाइज, दैट्स हाउ वी यूज दीज मॉडल्स टू टॉक अबाउट नेसेसिटी. And since the time is up, we will put an end to the session here today. But when we meet tomorrow, we will talk about 4 more usage of modals. And for today, I would like to give this task to you. I would like everyone to write at least one example for each use of modals. We talked about 4 different uses: to talk about ability, to talk about to ask permission, to talk about possibility, and to talk about necessity. We discussed these 4 usage. I would like you to write examples for each of these usage and use different modals and share those examples with me in the group. Or you can share with me 1-to-1 as well. You can share individually or in the group, and I will go through them. I will get back to you if there is any feedback. So please do that. So guys, that's all for today. I'm sorry, Aditya, I couldn't give you that opportunity, but I will give you more opportunities tomorrow. So please come prepared and participate. That's all for today, guys. In case you have any questions after the class, please feel free to ask me. Agar aapko kuch samajh mein nahi aaya hai, I'm there. You can ask me anything. You can ask me anytime. And don't compare yourself with others. Agar aapko aisa lag raha hai, mere ko samajh mein nahi aaya, shayad dusre logon ko samajh mein aa gaya. Doesn't matter. Aapko nahi aaya, so please ask questions. And please do the assignment. So that's all. Let's meet tomorrow. Good night, everyone.